What's good, YouTube? It is Aiden here. So I'm making this video because I always get asked the question, how did you know you were trans? It's a very common question. I know a lot of people get asked it. But before I get into that, I have decided that a hysterectomy is something that needs to be done within the next few years. I've always been told within 5 years of starting T, you should get a hysterectomy just for safety reasons. So pretty much what I decided to do was through 0.5 cc, I'm now going to take all the profit made from any Alliance Fear shirts made, which this is one of them. Any Alliance Fear shirt sold, and it's got the little needle, which can or cannot, doesn't have to be there. If you don't want it there, just write me a little email. So pretty much this shirt, it's like, it says Alliance Fears in here, plus another Alliance Fear design are both going to be, pretty much anything sold from them is going to go directly into that fund rather than the surgery fund that all the other shirts are donated to. So, yeah, that's pretty much that. But if you guys want to support me and you want to get a cool shirt in the process, I'll put the link below. You can get that shirt. So any kind of shirt sold that has this design on it will go towards that, which hopefully, you know, hopefully you guys will get them, and then I can start saving some money. otherwise, I do have a financial way of saving money too. So hopefully between the two, and I have health insurance, so hopefully between the two, I could get the, I think it's like 45% I need to cover, and they cover the other 55, something like that. So, yeah, besides that. So, how did I know I was transgender? Pretty much, I decided to go about this topic in a way that might be a little different. It's really going to be called, I didn't know I was transgender, okay? I was not one of the, honestly, I'd consider lucky or, I guess, well-knowledged people who knew at the age of 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 that they were not the gender that they were born as. I grew up with two older brothers, was raised by my mother, and saw my father every other weekend, so pretty much it was me with two older brothers, 3 years and 6 years older than me, and then there was me. I was the only girl in pretty much a whole side of the family, both sides of the family, my mother's and my father's side. I was the only girl up until about I turned 8 or 9, 10, something like that. Then I had a cousin who was born, and then I didn't have another girl cousin until about 3 years after that. So I was the only girl. And I got to do what I wanted to do. My brothers teased me, they beat me up, I beat them up, I fake cried to get my mom to yell at them. I mean, I played softball since I was about 6, I played soccer since I was like 4, I was on one of those baby leagues. I played roller hockey, I played, I skateboarded, I rollerbladed. I mean, I did everything and anything that I really wanted to do. My my brothers would play karate, and I would play karate with them. And I would climb trees, and I wore my brothers' jerseys, their clothes. You know, I was considered a tomboy at the time. That's what I was known as. Oh, the tomboy, you know. And I was okay with that. I used to actually get upset about it because I didn't really know what it meant. I just knew that they were making fun of me, so I didn't want to be made fun of. So I used to get really upset when people called me a tomboy. But I had a starter jacket that I wore every day to school. I would borrow my brother's. My mom had, 1 year my mom got me this, like, girly bike. It was a mountain bike for my birthday. I mean, for Christmas. And I got so mad at her because all I wanted was a mongoose. I don't know if you guys remember that those were really cool in, like, 1996. I really wanted a mongoose with the pegs on the front and the back so I could do cool tricks. You know, that's all I wanted. And I got this mountain bike, and I was so pissed off about it. Looking back now, I feel really bad about it. because I am viewing it now from a parent's eyes. Not that I am a parent, but, you know. And I feel like that'd be the worst thing ever if I spent, like, $300 on something for my kid, and then that morning they were like, I fucking hate this. So, point is, I didn't know I was transgender. I didn't really have to know. I had a crush on somebody in third grade, and my mom asked me, the first thing she asked me, I might have mentioned this story before, but the first thing she asked me on the way home from, like, Wendy's was, when I told her that I had a crush on somebody, she asked me, is it a boy or a girl? So right off the bat, I mean, third grade, I mean, I don't even know how old you are in third grade, but you're pretty young, and my mom knew that something was up. Maybe she didn't know for sure, maybe she had a hope in her heart that maybe I would be, you know, the little girl that she pretty much had embedded in her brain that she wanted, but she was open to things, obviously. You know, like I said, I got to play all the sports. I remember up until like fifth grade, I was able to beat all the boys at arm wrestling. All the boys were scared of me. You know, and then I got into middle school and I started going to Catholic school, and I just knew that I always wore shorts underneath my skirt because I hated the skirt. Girls used to roll their skirts, like roll the top up, and I used to roll it down so it would be longer. I mean, when I got into high school and you had to shave, I would wear knee highs. So I would only shave from here to here because this is where my skirt landed and this is where my knee high went. So I only shaved there. So down here was always nice and hairy. I mean, I was always into sports. So being like a sporty girl, I knew I was a lesbian because I liked girls. And that's just what I thought I was. I just thought I was a sporty lesbian, you know, part of my French butchy kind of lesbian. That's just what I thought I was, and that's how I was okay with it. You know what I mean? I started wearing boxers in like seventh grade. Then once I hit about 21, 22, I started noticing that something was definitely different, and that's when I, you know, realized that I was trans in that age. And then I started transitioning like 3 years ago. So I was like 23 when I actually started, 22, 23, when I actually started. I was actually 22 when I started transitioning in February. And then I turned 23 over the summer. And then I started hormones that fall. So, you know, I think with me, once I found out, I didn't know what transgender was. I knew that there were, all I knew when I was younger is that some boys dress like women, and most of them are prostitutes. I mean, I'm just being honest, and I know now that that's totally a stereotype, and it's totally not even really a correct stereotype, but that's what I knew, because I saw it in movies, or I was flipping through the TV and watching something I shouldn't have been watching because I was too young, you know what I mean? I didn't know what transgender was. I didn't know you could live that. Maybe if I knew that when I was younger, maybe I would have, you know, maybe I would have been more vocal about wanting to do that, or maybe I would have known earlier that I wanted to do that. But I didn't know I was transgender. I didn't. I had no idea. Maybe if I lived in a house where, you know, I was being the girl, I was made to do dishes or clean or cook or, you know, do my nails or what, you know. I didn't have those pressures of doing that. And honestly, I mean, I liked pink, and my rooms were pink, and I loved stuffed animals, and I loved Beanie Babies, and I loved NSYNC when they came out, and, you know, I loved all these girly things, and that was okay, and I loved all these boy things, and that was okay, too. So, to me, I was just lucky enough to grow up in a household where it was okay to be yourself, whatever that self may be. As I got a little older, I think my mom saw me changing a little bit more, and maybe, she used to press pocketbooks on me and dresses, but I mean, there came a point even when she stopped doing that, because it was like, listen, I'm not wearing a dress. You dress me up in the coolest, awesomest suit you want, but I'm not going to wear a dress. And she caught on to that. And right before I transitioned, I had a good year or two of some like big heartbreaks, and just, you know, I was going to community college and I didn't know what I was doing there, and I didn't really have a job that I liked, and it was, you know, I didn't even have a job at some point. So I started really venturing into, like, I lost a lot of weight in a very unhealthy way, and I started dressing very feminine and getting attention that way, but I didn't really like it. At the end of the day, I was just, like, I went to prom in, like, this hot little dress, and I took it off after, like, 2.5 hours, because all I wanted to do was to show those people that, like, you know, I am a human, and I, you know, look at me, instead of covering myself up in black and, you know, like, just being some, like, dykey lesbian from high school, you know what I mean? I'm the only out girl in school. I showed up to prom in some hot little dress, and everyone was like, oh, wow, you look great, wow, and then I left, because that's all I needed was for people to acknowledge me, you know what I mean? So, I didn't know I was transgender. I didn't. Do you know how I knew? I was, like, on YouTube or something, and a Maury clip came up about this guy who transitioned from female to male. Once I saw that, I looked at the suggested videos, and I watched video after video after video after video. Video. And then, oddly enough, that same week, my girlfriend at the time, she asked me, hey, you know, do you ever think about being a man? Like, just like that, when we were driving home from somewhere one day. And I was like, you know, it's really weird you said that, because I just happened to look at these videos, and then I showed her the videos, and then we both got obsessed with watching videos. And that's how I found out I was trans. That's how I knew. I mean, YouTube really showed me that that was the life I wanted. And literally, I started that in, like, February of that year, and by October, I was onto. Because once I knew that was my, I mean, like, I didn't have to go through all this horrible depression figuring out who it was. I had one episode where I made all these things, and I bought a packer, and I bought a binder, and then I just got rid of all of it. I deleted my YouTube, deleted this Facebook, a Twitter, all this stuff. That's actually why it was originally ALionsFears, one, plural, and then I had to make it plural because I deleted that account and made a new one. So now it's an ALionsFears. So, you know, yeah, I mean, I didn't know. I don't think you do know. And then all of a sudden, something clicks. Like, that's what happened to me. Something clicked, and something inside of me said, that's it. That guy on there, you're going to be that guy. You know what I mean? That's where you're supposed to be. And once I started the path, I made a really conscious effort to stay open about my emotions, and YouTube helped me with that too by making videos. And that's how I discovered that I was trans. I mean, it wasn't hard for me once I figured it out. I was very depressed, you know, throughout middle school and high school, and I didn't know why, and I was very depressed, and I used to cut myself as a self, like, you know, self-torture or whatever. I did that for a lot of years. You know, I was very depressed kid. I had friends and I had a family, but I wasn't happy with myself, and so I took it out on everything else that was around me. And that's when I did my most thinking and emotions, and then I figured I was gay, and then I was like, okay, that's cool, and then I found it okay with myself being more of the masculine, and that was cool, and, you know, but I just never felt complete. And once I discovered what trans was, I felt that little gap close. And I just went with it. I mean, it was like, you know, it's like finding, I don't know, a good analogy, but, you know, like, it's like once you get behind the wheel the first time ever, you're scared shitless. And then the third time, you're like, this is my car, and I got a driver's license, and I'm fucking driving. Screw all you people. I'm driving wherever, whenever. I don't care where I'm going. I'll just drive. You know what I mean? And it was kind of like that. It was like, once I got the car, once I got in the car, once I drove it around once for a test drive, I was like, all right, this is my car. Let's go. Let's buck it. You know what I mean? Like, it was easy. I didn't have to think twice about it. It just went. I followed all the steps. I did all the research. I traveled an hour and 45 minutes to therapy and to the clinic where the therapist was, and to get my shots and all that stuff. I mean, I did you know, I paid all this money out the ass to get there, to be seen. I freaking had to drive the other side of where I was at to, I was driving to the city, and then I was driving all the way out east. just to get my name changed, and, like, you know, it was a big process, but all of it felt relevant. It felt like that's what I was supposed to be doing, and I was, although it was a pain in the ass, I was happy with every pain in the ass thing I had to do, because it was one step closer to filling the gap. Yeah, so, I mean, you know, I didn't know I was trans. You want to know, you know, oh, how did I know I was trans? I didn't know. I wasn't 6. I wasn't 12. I wasn't 18. I was 22, 23 years old, and I discovered I was trans. That's when I knew. That's when I had lived all this life, and I was like, you know, I'm all right with myself, but something's not right. Like, something's still not right. And once I found that piece, I just shoved that shit in, and I was like, let's go. You know what I mean? So, all right, that's my response, 15, 16 minutes later. All right, guys, and if you'd like to support me and my hysterectomy, please go to the 0.5cc t-shirtcompany.com, buy one of these awesome shirts. There's another Alliance Fear version of this shirt, too, that also counts. And if you like any of the other shirts on there, or I'm not wearing the hat now, but any of the other hats, you know, anything I got on there, everything goes to supporting a surgery. So if you want to be a cool guy, cool girl, cool ally, and you want to support someone's surgery, but you don't have $100 to spend, go buy a shirt, you know, spend $25, including shipping, and, you know, support someone. It's an awesome thing to do, and we got some big things coming up for 0.5cc too, so keep your eye out for that. I'm kind of excited, but I don't want to say nothing yet, but, you know, get myself out there. All right, guys? That's it. All right.
Peace.